Space telescopes, telescopes in general, are astronomers' most powerful tool for looking back in time. Traveling back in time is the stuff of science fiction, but looking back in time is science fact, is something that we actually do. And it's made possible by the finite speed of light. And so if one looks at, say, a person in the room next to you, you're not seeing them as they are. You're seeing them as they were a few nanoseconds ago, because that's how long it takes light to travel about 1 meter, a few nanoseconds. So when we look at the sun, we're not seeing it as it is. We're seeing it as it was 500 seconds ago. If we look at the nearest star, we see it as it was 4 years ago. And with the Webb, we will be looking back in time more than 13 billion years to see the birth of the first stars and galaxies to form after the Big Bang. Well, the telescope looks, frankly, different than most other telescopes that you've seen pictures of. And all of those differences that you see are there to enable the Webb's unique science mission to see the birth of the first stars and galaxies in the universe, and to give humanity its first high-definition view of the infrared universe. The light from the first stars and galaxies is emitted in the ultraviolet part of the spectrum. But as it travels to us through the expanding space, the wavelength of that light is stretched to infrared wavelengths. And so to observe it today, we have to work in the infrared. So the things that make the JWST unique are its infrared capability in combination with the very large size of its primary mirror. And this giant primary mirror that the JWST has is the first time that any infrared telescope in space has had a giant mirror. And that mirror will give the JWST the ability to see fine detail that is very similar to Hubble's. And so the images will be as breathtaking as the Hubble images. And this will be the first time that humanity has seen the infrared universe in high definition. And for an infrared telescope to work well, it has to be made very, very cold, because anything that is warm emits infrared light. And if we didn't make the telescope very, very cold, it would be blinded by its own infrared emission. And so the JWST will not orbit the Earth the way the Hubble Space Telescope does. It will go to a special spot in space called the second Lagrange point of the Sun-Earth system. We just call it the L2 point for short. And we determined that if we put the JWST at this special spot in space, the L2 point, all the sources of heat on it would be lie in one direction. The sources of heat are the sun, the earth, and the moon. And from the L2 point, those sources are always in one direction. So we realized that we could deploy a giant sun shield such that the telescope will always live in the shadow of the sun shield. And in that configuration, it will cool passively by simply radiating its heat away to the cold darkness of space. Our whole lives are just a fleeting moment. The day-to-day tribulations that we torture ourselves with here on the Earth, whether it be politics or something else, all of it is terribly insignificant in terms of this universe that we're embedded in and that is evolving around us. The big picture is not the picture that we spend most of the time arguing with each other about in our lives on the Earth. And I'm hopeful that we'll be able to find a way to avoid destroying the Earth long enough for us to really understand the universe that we're embedded in, and long enough for us to really understand the worlds that we now know exist around nearly every star in the galaxy. Today, the search for life, the search for extraterrestrial life, is no longer the stuff of science fiction. There are billions of habitable worlds in our galaxy alone, and there are billions of galaxies. And so it's somewhat inconceivable that we are alone in the universe, but we've learned how to search for life on exoplanets, and now we need to begin the long, methodical business of doing that. JWST will start that process and do some spectroscopy, transit spectroscopy, as they call it, to understand exoplanet atmospheres, the chemistry of those atmospheres. The search for life should be some of the most exciting science that we do over the next 20 or 30 years in space astronomy with Webb and other missions. The highest priority mission that we will start building in this decade is very much focused on exoplanets and search for life.